At Toys for Tots, the hands of each and every volunteer really can't move fast enough.
Are you guys tired yet?
Master Sergeant Jose Rodriguez talks up his favorite volunteers.
You guys been here since 8 o'clock this morning, and they're still working, working hard. They haven't been slacking on me.
The Landon brothers, and really all volunteers, are working a fast pace to avoid what happened Tuesday when things shut down.
Chaotic.
Peyton Landon remembers it well.
There was a line of people, so it was kind of hard for them to keep up with it.
Such a large number of people came to pick up, and there just were not enough volunteers to handle it, so.
We had to turn away some people, but not turn away as far as not giving them any toys. We just told them they could come back the next day.
Hundreds of people were told to come back later this week. A day later, a new workflow has been implemented, but the root of the problem still remains.
When we have like 20 or 30 volunteers, everything goes real quick. But when we only have a couple, that's when it gets hard.
They need more volunteers.
We have a lot of people that could show up during the day, but at nighttime is when we fall short, from 5 to 9, 5 to 10.
They're serving 30,000 families this year.
Bicycle for the top one and then toys for that one.
That's 6,000 more than last year. Fortunately, the fix is simple. All they need is willing people.
They just come down here to a Fashion Square Mall. It's pretty easy to get here. And our volunteer coordinator sign them up. You just have to sign a waiver, and we'll get them to work.
More people to do this job.
Right here.
Find toys and deliver.
Maria Vasquez.
So that everyone waiting can have what most of us want, a happy holiday.
And Merry Christmas.